humans aren't the only organisms that cheat, taking more than their fair share. The bacteria that I study live inside legumes, where they help the plant by using the plant's energy to make fertilizer.
The US ranks 29th in the world in infant mortality, and more women die of childbirth-related causes today than 20 years ago.
Why do Northern Nigerian women go to school? What meaning are they making of their schooling experiences?
At a time when investors and producers can move money and commodities across national borders with unprecedented speed and ease, workers, and particularly workers from former European colonies, face a proliferation of restrictions on their movement and settlement, everything from fences and walls to elaborate systems of surveillance and detention.
Some of these bacteria cheat, siphoning away energy from fertilizer production and instead using it to make fat.
I've spent the last 8 years sitting on birth balls like this one and following pregnant women in the United States and the Netherlands as they prepare for and give birth at home.
Dropout rate is so high, like it's about 7.3 million in Northern Nigeria, out of which 60% of them are women.
It's becoming increasingly difficult for the police and the state to draw boundaries between these workers who are already part of local communities and who are helping the economy to grow and helping these corporations to prosper.
My research shows that childbirth is accomplished in different ways in different societies, and that home birth can be a legitimate option, even in developed countries with high-tech healthcare systems.
When the plant dies, these bacteria are released into the soil, and those with more fat have a higher chance of finding a plant in the future.
So it's not a question of what we want, what educators or policymakers want the women to learn, but what the women also want to learn, what they value, what their views are, what their interests are, what they care about. If those things are also brought into the curriculum, I think that education will be more meaningful for them.
I'm also interested in how these workers are mobilizing politically in ways that cut across national boundaries and how they challenge our ideas about national identity and labor.
This work, in combination with other research in our lab, helps us understand how cooperation can be stable and maintained through thousands of years when cheaters are present. In addition, it provides novel opportunities to improve agriculture.